Hi all, first of all thank you so much for the amazing response on the video series which I had made. Today I'm here to discuss with you a real life incident, a short story which I've named it as The Other Side. Angela was really excited today because her daughter, who is a 12 year old kid, made it to the grand finale of state level chess championship. If she wins this, she'll be going ahead for the national level chess championship. This was a dream come true, but she was really nervous, so she decided to call Sagarika, her chant group head. She called Sagarika and said, "Hi Sagarika, I'm really nervous. You know, my daughter's made it to the finale and her finals are just in an hour or so. I want you to chant for her." Sagarika to this promptly replied, "I'm sorry dear, I'm outside somewhere. I don't think so it will be possible for me to chant for coming 3-4 hours. It will be great if you chant for her because you're her mother. So I'm sure this is gonna work out. You know, all the best." And she hung up the phone. Angela was really angry and pissed off. "Sagarika asked me to join this chant group 3 months back. I was not even keen on joining this chant group. I don't even believe in this. I believe in God. I believe in worship and praying, but I believe in praying alone. I never wanted to be a part of this group. I'm not going to this group again." Angela never went to that group ever again. But the common friend who made Angela and Sagarika meet organized a party. Angela was really scared that she might meet Sagarika, so she was trying to escape the party as soon as possible, but she met Sagarika. Sagarika came, gave her a big smile and started talking to her. Angela didn't want that topic to come up in between as to why she's not attending the chant group meetings, so she immediately tried to change the topic by saying, "Oh Sagarika, you've got a nice haircut. Where did you get it from? Because last time I remember you had pretty long hair. Now you're looking very modern." Sagarika said, "Unfortunately, this is not a haircut. This is a natural thing. Last month, I was detected with cancer, so I had to undergo chemotherapy. Actually, I wanted to apologize for my behavior last time. I was in the chemotherapy session, so I quickly answered your phone and I couldn't pray because I knew that for coming 3-4 hours, I'd not be in a physical state to pray. So I didn't want to lie to you." Angela couldn't hold back her tears. She was cribbing about such a petite thing, just a state level championship, where Sagarika was struggling with her life, trying to live her life, struggling with the chemo sessions, struggling with her cancer. She felt really small. She felt and she thought that what did she do and why did she stop talking to Sagarika, such a petite thing, without knowing the other side of the story. This is what happens to us as humans. We fail to look at the other side of the story and we jump on to conclusion. The amazing part is, although it is very difficult to become a judge, but we have judges sitting in every home, in every corner of the world, who are ready to judge the other people without knowing the entire story. So next time, when you start judging people, just think about the other side. And also, if next time people start judging you without knowing your side of the story,
just remember that we all have hired a lot of people out there in the market whose job is just to criticize us. And the best part is, they don't even charge salary for that. Take care. Thank you.